You know, it's always nice to have groomed and presentable outfits, and a part of that is having your clothes pressed or ironed. And today we're going to look at ironing of some jeans, after which we're also going to fold them very nicely. Also, we're going to iron some shirts, and after, we're going to fold them in a way so that they can be stackable, so you don't have to always hang your shirts. You can stack them like this too, and it looks just as organized and neat as it is when they're hanging, okay? And for this, we're going to need a lint roller to pick up those pesky little sticky hairs and pieces of lint and so forth. Also, we're going to need spray water. Any water will do. And we'll need an iron. My iron is quite sturdy and quite heavy, which makes it quite easily maneuverable on most surfaces, which is perfect for this activity. So let's start. So this is our ironing board, and you will notice that I'm going to utilize this corner quite a lot. It's actually quite convenient to use this more than the rest of the board. Here's our iron. We're going to set it for no steam. And we're going to click it onto. I'm going to put it for cotton setting, just because most of our clothing is going to be made of cotton. So we'll start the jeans by placing them over the edge of the table again, and you will see that there's some embroidery, and I'm not going to go over with my iron over it, just to make sure that I don't melt away the glue and don't pick up the design, okay? But we will do our best to go around each side, okay? As always, we're grabbing a lint roller, cleaning just some parts. I'm going to take my spray bottle and just spritz just a tiny bit, just like so. And I'm just going to go in, and again, as awkward as it is, there is only one way to iron it. Now we will gently turn it learn this part, but you can do your best. Okay, now we're going to turn it onto the front part. Again, I usually just keep twisting it if I have to. Just like this. Just picking up any extras. Okay. I'll spray. Spray a little bit here. Make sure to protect your fingers at all times. Let's turn them over. Do the same thing on the other side. And you know, it's sometimes almost impossible to work these fake pockets with things that are just very small. Definitely makes it harder, but we always do our best. Plus, let's face it, most of the time the tap is not even visible. But as always, we do our best. Okay. So now we're going to turn these around and just iron the rest. Like to just stretch. Straighten out everything, every cranny. This bottom piece oftentimes starts curling up, you know? So you want to just keep it down and maybe a spray. So, okay. And we'll just spritz mostly at the bottom. Okay. We'll take our iron and we'll do long pressing lines. To make sure that the bottom part is more flattened out. Very good. We'll do the same thing on the other leg. And then we'll do the same on the front. Just pressing. Stretching it out. You can pull on the sides. We'll just kind of tug it down again. This edge is always so independent. It just wants to stay curled. But we don't want it. We want it to be down and nice and pressed. Clean up with our lint roller. Just go over the knee here. Okay. And I'll spritz again. At the edges right here. Just to make sure that we do enough of impact. A similar way. I'm just going to run it all the way from the top down to the bottom. The same way on the other side. I'm just going to pull it away. Watching for our fingers. Safety is always first. Yeah. Don't let the iron run away from you. Okay. And now we're going to fold the jeans. I usually prefer to fold them like so. Just folding them in half. Right after I ironed them. Okay. Straighten them out. I'll show it to you better here. Make sure there's no wrinkles. We don't want no extra wrinkles. Okay. Just got rid of all of them. Don't need no other ones. Okay. So, then we'll fold this corner in like this. And we'll bring the leg part up to the top. There's a couple of ways to do this, but this is the most easiest. And create a fold this way. Clean out your fold at the bottom. And press on top. This way this part will stay inside your jeans fold. Okay? And then create a second fold. Just kind of position it. A little better. And of course, again, depending on the design and on the shape, on the stretch of your jeans, the fold is going to be according as well. So if you have like skinny jeans, it might look more compact. Basically, we're done. We have the bucket facing up. This way, it's easier to find it in the stack, particular one, because let's face it, most of the time, pocket is something that differentiates one pair from the other. Okay. So that's our jeans. I really enjoy this pair a lot. It's my favorite. These are my jeans, obviously. Okay. We're going to iron a white, crisp shirt today. It is made by Calvin Klein. It's a regular fit. It's a large size and it's 100% cotton. It's quite a nice shirt. You can already see that we're going to deal with a little fold inside. It always wants to stay curled in again, so we'll need to make sure that we press it and then press down with our iron on it to make sure that it stays down like this and doesn't want to go out and party, so to say. So let's lay it out. Prefer to start with ironing the collar first. Okay. As always, I like to use the roller right away to get everything out of the way. We usually would just press with the heel of the iron and just go all the way. Very good. Sometimes the corners could curl up too, so make sure you press them down nice and firmly. Next we'll do shoulders, or yoke area as they call it. And this is when the pointy part of your table comes in handy. You would just put your shoulder over, and it creates a very nice and stretched area for you here to work with. It's quite open space, so again, it's very easy to maneuver. Your collar is standing up nice and straight since we already pressed it. So let's remove if you like your shirts more crisp, more harsh, I would recommend using some starch sprays. I'll be honest with you, I don't use it. I feel like as a society, we hopefully moved past that part. But it is definitely something that you're welcome to experiment with. And so now we're just going to literally maneuver with our iron, all around, lifting the corners if need to. Otherwise, it's quite simple. And I like to press it extra hard with a little bit of steam, like this. Okay. You can see how nice and clean this looks now. Mm-hmm. Going to change sides. Mm-hmm. Carefully not to wrinkle the side we just ironed. just rolling. And you will be surprised that by using the lint roller, how much you can pick up. So maybe I'll show you at the end, but it picks up much more than you ever imagined. Yep. So it's definitely very good touch to do. Make sure you do it. So now once again, we're going to just go on this pattern now. Nothing better than the smell of steamed, freshly washed clothes, isn't there? Like a clean laundry smell, and then with iron on top of it, it's just paradise. To me personally. Now we're going to go onto our arm, our shoulder part. Roll your lint if it needs any. We're going to take our iron and we're just going to roll it. Right over it. And don't expect perfection. It just will not be there. Do it as well as you can. Do it on the other side too. Now, I usually like to have a crease when I iron the shirts, so they usually keep a very good memory of it. You can see they kind of just automatically go into that position, into that shape. Rolling away our problems, yeah. So here we're going to start at the edge. We're going to go right towards the cuff. I might need my spray here. Okay. Do not feel bad for using the spray. Spray can really save you sometimes. Can really give it just that extra relaxed feel to your to the clothes, to the fabric. Just what you need. Go up the shoulder with the corner out, and then we're going to lift this part up and go into this little crease with the corner, with the pointy part of our iron, like this. Wonderful. Try to do the same without creating any new wrinkles, okay? Mm-hmm. spritz. Once again, going with the heel of the iron, going towards the shoulder real quick, and then doing a long swipe while you pull up the cuff. Then roll over, same thing with the heel, and roll it up. Same on the other side. Now let's move to our front part. And again, we're going to utilize our ironing board for this. As you can see, I'm just wrapping around. Until the seam of the shirt right here. This gives me a perfectly stretched fabric that we can easily glide over. I will do a spraying again. And one more time, we're going to grab a piece of fabric here. We're going to tug it up at the same time as we're bringing in the iron up too, from the bottom up. Just like so. And then we run it down, press. Here and just run it towards it. Grab a piece here, you can go down too. And now we'll go over the buttons. And ironed. For the other side, you'll need to do the same thing, but you will need to come from the opposite side towards you. And this is the part that I was telling you about. See how it wants to stay curled up? Right here. So I'm going to just spend time on it separately. I'm going to make sure I press it down. And I just run over it. Before I start the rest of it, up and down. Good. This will save us some headache. Now you see it doesn't want to curl up anymore. Thank you. spray. We'll right away press the pocket in place so it doesn't start flopping around. Okay? And same way, we're going to press a little bit here, pull it, and run our iron right towards it. Same thing, grab a piece of fabric here too. And run. Don't burn yourself, of course. One more time. I need to spend more time here. Let me just out once and for all, hopefully. Okay, so a little bit of sprayer actually does the trick most of the time, but it could fight your lint too. Seems to be really fighting me right now. Does not want to straighten out. It's a shame, but I will live with that. So now, as before, we just keep rolling. Now we're bringing in our back. Again, rounding it up by the side seam and up until the yoke area again, the shoulder. And lint is something that you don't really have to do, but to my experience, it really does the trick. Really, really make a difference. Okay, slightly spray the surface area. Let me try to flatten out this part right here already. I see it, it's going to bug me now. And just again, we pull and twisting up until the next seam is visible. Same way. Yep. Quite an easy trick, isn't it? So spray him again. Press at the bottom. And pull again. Becomes almost a dance. After a while, so used to all the motions and the movements, that it becomes an extension of you. It's very easy for you to figure out how to iron certain clothes, certain fabrics. It becomes a second nature. I used to watch my mom and my grandmother iron everything all the time. They would iron every clothes because we didn't have a dryer, so there was no way to do anything wrinkle-free. And I kind of got that from her and always enjoyed this time. Also find it to be very attractive. If that makes sense. I always feel like when you iron somebody else's clothes, it's pretty much total sacrifice for the good of the person. Even when you cook dinner, you still cook it partially for yourself. But when you iron or wash somebody's clothes, it's an ultimate sacrifice almost. You're doing it for them so that they will look groomed and pleasant and presentable. So I think it's very important to do that. And again, I find it very attractive. So now let's fold it. So before we fold it, we need to button it up. So we'll button up the top button to keep the color in place. Yeah. I'm having difficulties with the buttons today for some reason. And then maybe like third one down too. Okay. Now we want to turn her around. Straighten it out. We're going to fold one side in. Pretty much up until the middle of this part. As you fold again, try not to create new creases, new wrinkles. We'll take the handle, the arm. We'll bend it down. And then up. Something like this. We'll do the same thing. Side. Let's bring it in. Folding in. Then back up. And I like to stack them together, the two cuffs on top of each other, right under our collar. And then we're going to fold it one more time. And nicely folded, freshly ironed shirt. This way, he can put them together like this. You don't have to always hang them. Here we have jeans. If you're traveling, it's a perfect package. Okay. So I hope that was interesting and relaxing as well as informative. Thank you for